We are arresting. We are charging. We are investigating all bad actors.
Thank you very much. You're watching Chair Gaines, members of the Police Services Board.
And it has had a measurable impact on your lives, on families' lives, business livelihoods, residents have been the victims of intense noise, threatening behavior, hateful vitriol, and has no place in our city or anywhere in our country. Businesses have had to close. We've lost employees. We've lost their livelihoods. In some cases, they've shuttered and closed. Our officers have been pushed to the limit. They've been injured. They're fatigued beyond my ability to describe. While I was traveling throughout devastation areas, Center Town, the market, Town, Sandy Hill, over the course of the previous 24 hours. An elderly couple, both in wheelchairs, both of them significantly infirm, approached me. They thanked me for the work that the officers have been providing for them. They implored me to find ways to better serve them. Encouraged me to find a way to end this as safely as possible for everybody, recognizing the near impossible circumstances that we're facing this. While I was at City Hall visiting our officers down there and agreeing with local negotiations, I saw a married couple of the little baby daughter literally getting married. They came over and asked me as chief, was it safe for them to go home after their marriage ceremony? Was it safe for their daughter? We spoke at length. They again thanked me and asked me to pass on those thanks to my officers and our partners. They again expressed that they knew how difficult, almost impossible it was in the circumstances that we and the residents and the businesses are facing. I saw one of our emergency service unit officers literally helping a homeless person to drink from a bottle of water and enabling that person to get the services they need. In the middle of the demonstration zone, with heavy trucks, heavy noise, heavy diesel, heavy fear all around. These are a thousand other activities that are taking place around this city for the past year. While we've made significant progress in reducing the impacts of the demonstration on our residents, on our businesses, on all people in Ottawa, and on our service members, there remains an incredible amount of risk and an incredible amount of work to get done. I want to thank the members of the Ottawa Police Service and our partner agencies, City of Ottawa work staff, provider indoor services, roads, emergency transport. I want to thank our police partners, federal, provincial, and municipal. I want to thank Steve Panalakis for his leadership as a city manager, Governor Watson, his leadership, chair meetings, members of our board. I have four core messages to deliver, and then I will start to turn things over to the rest of the presentation. To the unlawful demonstrators, let me be clear once again, there are consequences for your behavior. There have been arrests made, there have been charges laid, there are more coming, they will be announced even today. It does not matter how long it takes, we will find those who committed the criminal acts, we will lay charges against them, and they will face the possibility of jail as a result. There is no statute of limitations for criminal acts in this country. And there is nowhere you can go in this country that we cannot find you and bring you to justice. Number two, those that have significantly contributed the majority of the traffic chaos we have enjoyed in the city, including those of you who live out of province and registered your vehicles out of province, deep out of country, there will be charges pursued against you, no matter where you're from. Those of you who have committed acts of hate crimes, criminal offenses, we will charge you and you will face prosecution. That includes those who desecrated our monuments, particularly the cemetery. There is an active criminal investigation with the persons involved in the desecration of the cenotaph. We'll hear more later from Deputy Chief Steve Bell on the status of that investigation. The residents of Ottawa, the business owners of Ottawa, the people of Ottawa, we know you're hurting. We know you want more action. You're escalating our actions, including enforcement. We're going to do so without unnecessarily escalating greater public safety risks. We do not want riots. We can never accept serious injuries or deaths. But all options remain on the table. Today, the command team and I are here to provide you the most up-to-date information possible. Intelligence information, investigation information, operations information. We're going to let you know as clearly as we can the appropriate context, the full nature of the threats, the risks, the unlawful conduct, the volatile elements that this disruptive demonstration has had and continues to have. As the chair and the mayor mentioned, this is a unique, unprecedented demonstration, one that is extremely well funded, one that comes with extensive public safety risks. This demonstration is local. Affects us here in the nation's capital. It affects Ottawa residents, Ottawa business owners, but it is provincial, it is national, and it is increasingly international. The individuals have come from every part of Canada here to Ottawa, even Ottawa residents participating in demonstrations. We are now aware of a significant element of the United States that have been involved funding, the organizing, and the demonstration. They have converged in our city, and there are plans for more to come. It's putting our city, our residents, our partners, and our officers at great risk. We're doing our very best to manage this risk. Again, we are grateful for the fact that there have been no riots, no injuries, no deaths to date. We cannot rest on any laurels. There's no reason to celebrate them there. Those are just facts. But there have been a lot of trauma, a lot of troubles hoisted on this city. We are arresting, we are charging, we are investigating all bad actors, all criminals, and enforcement will continue. All options are on the table. This has truly become a whole of service, whole of community, whole of city, and increasingly whole of country effort. We've been working with all three levels of government, including all three levels of policing and public safety agencies, municipal police services, provincial police services, the federal police service, RCMP, national security agencies, increasingly our border agencies. All options for the resolution of this demonstration are on the table, from a negotiated resolution to an enforced resolution. Let me be clear, all such options come with significant risks. Risk to rioting, risk to injury, and risk to death. Not only are we deploying all available county police resources every day, but we have also requested and received additional officers and resources from the RCMP, the OPP, and many other municipal police agencies across Ontario. We have gathered together some of the top policing experts, public safety experts, including the top public border commanders in the province and federally, to explore and prepare a range of options to end this demonstration as safely and effectively as we possibly can. We are monitoring demonstrations that are taking place across this country, from British Columbia to Alberta to Quebec and beyond. I have been in contact within the last 24 hours with our city commissioner, Brenda Lutton, specifically in regards to the demonstration that is taking place in Alberta near the border, a small town of 240 people. For those of you that have been following that particular demonstration, you can see that the very first attempt to enforce an end to that demonstration was unable to do so, created immediate public safety risks. It included vehicles being driven towards the officers, dangerous collisions resulting from that, and immediate refilling of the spaces that were cleared from the initial accident. All of which are elements of the country's work. Scale and the complexity of the danger is exponentially more so than that particular thing. Hope and safety of all police officers, responders, residents in that town. We're hearing about similar demonstrations on the way, and the plan to be in the very near future across this country.
Oh, God bless you. You taking my picture for the newspaper?
You want to be on the camera?
Don't take it for the
police. I'm taking a picture of the building.
Oh, yeah?
But you want to be on camera?
Candid camera? Alan Fun?
Well, no, I'm not hiding.
Oh. Eric Hyden, the skater.
Well, you know what? Don't trust anybody who hides their face. You don't need the mask.
Who widens? Whitens?
Who hides his face.
Justin Trudeau's getting his ass kicked lately. You ought to hear the horns going up and down here. The big truckers don't like it. I don't know what he did to them, but they don't like it.
Stay strong.